If you're building applications and need to manage application secrets, or maybe you're managing infrastructure and need to keep those encryption keys secret, I just got the right service for you. This is Adam, and welcome to Introduction to Azure Key Vault Service. Okay, so let's talk about Key Vault. Key Vault has two main purposes. One is centralization, and second is protection. Protection of your application secrets, encryption keys for your infrastructure and disk management, certificates, but also has advanced features like HSM protection of your secrets if you need something more advanced. So the common cases for using Key Vault is, for instance, web applications. Normally within web application, when you're connecting to a database, you're storing connection strings, and you usually use upsettings for that. What you can do using Key Vault is move those connection strings into the Key Vault so that your secrets are protected, but also not visible in the portal. So it's a great use for also operational perspective. Once the connection strings are secured in a Key Vault, you can reference them from the web application using something called Key Vault Reference. And you simply just use this magic string on application settings, and it will automatically pull the value from the Key Vault, granted that there is an access given for the web application. Although this way of referencing has a couple of disadvantages. First of all, this doesn't work on Linux app setting, so it's not very good this way. Also, you will see that key in the portal. From the operational perspective, that is also unacceptable. And a third, this reference requires you to specify a secret version. So if you're rolling keys, you will need to replace that manually. So it's not the best way. Better way is to reference this through code. So it only takes 5 lines of code in a .NET core to use a manage identity, connect to Key Vault, and grab this key yourself. So it's pretty flexible. The common other scenarios are centralizing secrets. So if you have multiple services that need to use the same connection string, you can use actually Key Vault to centralize the setting. So when your operational people will actually replace these connection strings, all the referencing services will get the updated version. And lastly, one of the most common use cases for the infrastructure management is disk encryption. So using simply CLI, PowerShell, or maybe ARM template, you can encrypt your disks using Key Vault and store that encryption key in a Key Vault service itself. There are a couple of additional features that Key Vault include. For instance, firewall, so you can get this advanced authorization access from specific networks in Azure or specific IPs. You have also auditing, so you can verify and see in the logs who was accessing your Key Vault secrets and when. With Azure Active Directory integration, you can actually very nicely manage access to your Key Vault through Azure Active Directory accounts or applications. You have also replication, so you're making sure that your content is always replicated, so you're never gonna lose it. And lastly, there's always the dynamic scaling, so whatever your usage is, Key Vault will handle it and will serve you very nicely. And lastly, you can access Key Vault through multiple ways. One of the most powerful is REST API, allowing you to connect from pretty much any application out there. But also, you have out-of-the-box SDKs for Java, .NET, some modules for Node.js, libraries for Python, and always you are there with CLI and PowerShell, so you can script and automate your Key Vault access. So I have 3 demos for you today. First of all, I will show you how to create and manage your Key Vault. Then I will do 2 applications. First of all, I'm gonna make a client application logic apps, which will connect to Key Vault and grab a secret. And also I will use a data factory, which will store secrets and consume them in Key Vault for the ETL purposes. So let's go into the portal. So in the portal, click on the plus to search for the Key Vault. Hit enter, pick the Key Vault service, hit create. And of course, you need to provide a resource group name, you need to provide a name, A4E Key Vault. This has to be globally unique because this is gonna be your address for the Key Vault service. You need to provide a region, for me that's gonna be North Europe, and a pricing tier. Of course, the only difference in the pricing is for premium, you also get this SHM for your advanced secrets management. But we're gonna pick standard today. I'm gonna hit review and create, validation passed, and hit create. So I'm gonna wait here for a minute. After about 30 seconds, the Key Vault has been provisioned, so I can hit go to the resource and show you how it looks. So first of all, this is your DNS name. This is the public URL for your Key Vault service. This is especially important if you're using REST API. You have the pricing information here in the directory, some total requests, but the most important things are always on the left-hand side. So you have your keys, secrets, and certificates, the three most important things that you actually use the Key Vault for. But additionally, you have access policies. This is where you manage access to your Key Vault. And as you see, out of the box, I got, as a user, access to Key Vault with all the privileges to manage keys, secrets, and certificates for my Key Vault. So remember that this is a very important section, because out of the box, you get, even though you are an owner to the Key Vault, you also need to have access to the data within the Key Vault, to the keys, secrets, and certificates specifically. So if you're starting with Key Vault, remember to grant yourself an access here so you can actually manage the keys yourself. If you need to add anything new, just hit add access policy here and give access to an application or maybe additional users. Of course, you also have firewalls here, so we were talking about that. If you want to narrow down the access to the Key Vault to specific virtual networks or IPs, you can do it from here. So what would be the demos that we'll work on today? I actually have in my resource group prepared two things. I have a logic app and a data factory. I'll start from the logic app. So for the logic app, if you go there, let's start from something simple. Let's start from HTTP request as such as manual execution step. Let's add a new step and search for Key Vault. There's an Azure Key Vault step, which allows you to get a secret. Before we proceed here and log into Key Vault, on the second tab, I will actually open that Key Vault again, go to the resource group, go to the Key Vault, go to secrets, and I will actually create one of the secrets. So this time I'm uploading a manual. I'm gonna give it a name. I'm gonna call it my secret, and the value will be 123. And everything as default. One of the cool features, you can actually set activation date and expiration date for your secrets if you want to do some advanced rolling security options that this key will expire at some point. And you can always disable and enable this key to be active or inactive. So I'm gonna hit create. Now I have my secret. So what I need to do right now is go back to the logic app. We need to provide the name of the vault. The easiest is just to copy the name from the portal. So let's provide it, hit sign in. And once the pop-up is there, just hit continue. Once you logged in, it will create a connection to that Key Vault. And if you have permissions, you should see from the dropdown your secret. You can actually save this and hit run. So let's see the output. Within a couple of seconds, you will see that we'll get a value of our secret in the logic app. So successfully check the trigger and we see that we pulled the secret of value 123. As you can imagine, this is not the best scenario, but it also shows the principle of logging using my personal account, using logic apps into Key Vault and pulling in the secret. In case of logic apps, always advise you to go to settings and select secure output so that the secret is not visible in the logs. The second way you can actually work with logic apps and the, let me actually close this and delete this. So the second way you can actually pull the secret is using actually manage identity. So I'm gonna save this and show you how to do that. Because right now I was using my own account, but of course you should either use service principal or you can use manage identity. To do so, you go to back to logic app, go to identity, select it as on, enable manage identity for logic app. Once this is done, you will go back to your Key Vault and you need to grant access of this manage identity to your Key Vault service. So you go back to Key Vault, you go to access policies. And of course, in previous scenario, I didn't have to do it because I was using my own account and I have access to this key vault. But now I'll be using managed identity, which is different from my own personal account. Therefore, I need to grant it an access to the key vault service. So you add access policy. The only thing you will need here is actually from the secrets, you need a get and list if you need. And then you need to select a service principal. This can be either user or application. In case of managed identity, this is an application. So you need to select it. From the principal panel, you need to type demo. And this is demo 1 logic apps. Select it, hit add. And very important thing that most people forget here is to hit save. Remember to hit save or your application will be, your settings will be lost on closing this window. So go back to Logic App Designer. And right now you can actually use maybe HTTP requests. I'm going to show you how to connect through the REST API. So use the HTTP. This will be a GET request. You need the URI. To get the URI, just go to your secrets, hit on the your secret, click on the current version, and grab secret identifier. This is the URI. At the very end, this is the secret version. One, each secret can have multiple versions, but cool thing is that if you don't specify it, it will pull the latest value. One important thing is here that you need to add an API version in order to be able to call it through the REST API. Once you do it, the only thing you need now is to select authentication. So how you're gonna call this API? I will actually authenticate through managed identity, which I just created and given an access. Now just set an audience. An audience is a very important thing. And you need to set it to vault-azure.net. That means when this will be executed, a managed identity will go to Azure Active Directory, get a token for this service, for this audience, which is vault-azure.net, and using this token will send a request to this secret, to this key vault A4E key vault, get to the secret endpoint and grab my secret value. So let's see if that works. Let's hit save and hit run. I'm gonna hide this and see the execution of our logic app. Right now we successfully checked the trigger and it finished correctly. We got a response of 200 and the value was 123. That was very easy, wasn't it? Right now I have shown you how to use RESTful endpoint and also how to use out-of-the-box connector using logic apps. But also a very common case for using Key Vault and secrets is using Data Factory. Data Factory is your ETL tool that allows you to connect from multiple services. And when saving connection to those services, you can actually use Key Vault for that. So let's go to our resource group, go to the Key Vault and open Data Factory. Hit out on a monitor and open Data Factory window. In here, go to the Outer tab and go to connections. And first of all, you need to create a connection to your Key Vault. Hit new, find a Key Vault on this list, hit continue, call it my Key Vault, select it from Azure subscription, and of course, don't forget to test connection. And if everything is fine, you should see connection successful message, hit create. Once you have the Key Vault link service, which means your Data Factory can connect to your Key Vault, just remember very important thing. Right now it can connect there, but you need to give an access. So go back to your Key Vault, hit on it, go to access policies and grant access to the Data Factory. So again, add access policy. You need the secret permission get and list. In the particular case, you could just select get. But list is also nice for some features. So select principal, type demo. In this case, this is the demo to Data Factory. Select, add, always remember the save button. Right now your Data Factory have an access to read secrets from the Key Vault. So since we have the Link service defined, so this is how your data factory knows which key vault to use. And we have given an access to the data factory to use the key vault service. Let's do a quick demo test. So in my resource group, I have a storage account. So I will go here to access keys and copy a connection string. Since I have a connection string copied, I'll go to my secrets, generate or import, I will call it storage and paste the value of the connection string into the secret. You can always click on the storage, check the current version. You can even display the secret value. So as you see, this is our connection string to the storage account. Now in the data factory, you can actually hit new, click on the Azure Blob Storage, and here select Azure Key Vault instead of connection string. When you do it, just select your link service to your Key Vault, give it a secret name, our was called storage. And if this works, if your Key Vault is actually granting an access to this data factory, you can actually hit test connection. And if everything works, a connection is successful. So you just hit create. And right now your data factory will be connecting to this blob storage using Key Vault and the latest version of the secret. This is super amazing in terms of operations. So let's do a very quick demo here. Let's go back to storage and regenerate the key. This should successfully drop what we currently have and replace it with a new key, including new connection string. So if you go back to data factory and test the connection, it will now fail because the key vault now currently holds the old value. So if you copy the new connection string and go to key, go back to storage and hit a new version and give it a new value and save it. Now, if you go back to test the connection, you will see that connection is successful. This is how you can manage centrally your keys. So let's close off with a couple of things. First of all, in the Key Vault itself, let's go back to Key Vault. Actually, maybe use this tab. Go back to Key Vault. Remember that each secret has a version and you can retrieve that version by specifying this version ID in the URL. If you don't specify it, you always will get the latest. But of course, you can always check the version history for each key in a Key Vault. Those are the most common cases for the Key Vault. In the next episodes, I'll also show you how to encrypt drives using Key Vault. But for today, these are the most common cases of using Key Vault for the application secrets. There are many more scenarios that you can use Key Vault for, but today I just want to leave you with one important thing to remember. If you're managing secrets, certificates, or encryption keys, Key Vault is the right service for you. And the more secure you want to be, the more reasons to use Key Vault service. To be honest, I use it in pretty much any applications that I do. If you like this video, hit thumbs up, leave a comment, and subscribe if you want to see more, and see you next time.